The Fox Hunt. Autumn has come, and crisper nights, and flocks of birds on southward flights. And yellowed leaves now start to fall as breezes turn to rain and squall. Now Freddie Fox has made a start on slowly, gently trying to part from parents, siblings, and his home. And is trying very hard to comb the countryside for territory, not regarded as proprietary at this the time of equinox to any other roaming fox. And back from holidays in Spain, the hunting men refreshed again, fish out their horns, their whips and hats, their jumpers, riding coats, cravats. With saddle, blinkers, reins and bit, they on tall hunters stately sit. Replete with sherry from the pub, they set off to dispatch a cub. This these country folk can do with subsidies from the EU. Fox hunting is provocative, depending upon where you live. Townies think this red marauder is part of nature's pecking order. If they say a fox is slain, at least his death should be humane. To farmers, foxes are a pest, all about them they detest. Whatever your viewpoint or conclusions, foxes have but few illusions. Hounds come, tear your limbs apart, rip out your throat and eat your heart. Alternatively, a different plot, all are at risk of being shot. A survey of foxes in the field has unsurprisingly revealed that most respondents, to be blunt, would sooner face a full-blown hunt than die with neither fight nor flight, shot with a telescopic sight. With hunts they often win campaigns by subtle exercise of brains, outwitting huntsman, horse and hound, by pretending to go underground. But whether he's hunted just for fun or tracked by farmer armed with gun, your fox is wondrous philosophic. Losses are far from catastrophic. So, humans take a clutch of lives, but that is why we have our wives. Soon after death, the den resounds with little cub and vixen sounds. For every fox they're forced to mourn, another little fox is born. So by and large, as a corrective, slaughter isn't that effective.